to KO tutorials. So let's continue with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as you can see over here, we have started texturing this game assets over here. So let's continue it. So as you can see over here, we have done some texturing to some of the assets over here. So let's just open the reference over here. So we'll just open up a reference. So I'll again go over here and I'll take one concrete over here. So let's take a concrete material. So if you want any kind of ground crumble or something, I can even assign this. I have a grass dirt, so I have multiple elements over here. So let's go over here and let's assign a concrete over here. So let's just drag over here. So I'll just assign a material over here for this. So as you can see, we have assigned a material. Also, again, I'll go over here and again, I'll go into this and I'll take a metal over here. So let's take iron raw metal over here and I'll just assign a metal shader. So as you can see now, I have assigned a metal shader, and with that I'll just assign a steel rust on top of this. So let's just assign a steel rust over here. So again, I'll go over here, I'll again go into this, and if you want to add some metal rust on top of it, I can add a bit of metal rust on top of it. So this looks better. So for the wires, I can just go into this and if you have any kind of, I can go into this and say plastic grainy, or you can go with any rubber or something, copper as well. So you can, so we do have copper only one reference, so I can just go into this and I'll just assign this in this way. So as you can see now, so we have assigned the material. Similarly, I'll assign it over here as well. So we have assigned this. So for the pole, what I'll be doing over here, I can just open up a reference over here. I'll just open up a reference and again I'll go into this. We can add some metal material on top of it. This looks a bit better. With that, I can add some iron raw as well. So I can add a iron raw material on top of it. So this looks, so again I'll go into this and let's add a black mask. So I'll just add a generator and I'll go into this and say a metal edge wear. So I can just add a metal edge wear if required. So we do have this wear level. So if it is required, we can just go with that. Similarly, again, we do have this steel rough. I can put it on top of it according to your needs. I can just place it. Same here. I'll assign a steel material over here, and for this again I'll go into this, I'll add a rusty dark metal on top of it. So we can just assign a rusty dark metal . All right, and if you want to add something more that can be added, and if you go into this, and if you want to add some red steel painted bone over here as well, that can also be added. All right. It's a bit heavier. So we'll just delete that. Instead of that, if any other material iron forged, we can add it once if needed over here. Then you can just go over here and add a black mask if needed. Then you can go into this polygon fill, then if you want to show, you can just show on the areas. Where it is actually required. So we need to go over here and make that selection. So over here as well, so if needed you can just use it. Oops, so I can again, I'll go into this. So again I'll go into mask, and again I'll go into the polygon fill. All right. So we can still select this. So we can do some subtractions if needed. So again I'll go into this, again I'll go into the metal and I can just add a steel gun metal over here on top of it. All right. So guys, if any doubts, please put it in the comment section over here. So please like and subscribe my YouTube channel if you're not subscribed yet. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the coming tutorial. So thanks for watching this tutorial. So we can just save it once.